Everyone, in this video we are going to see about curves and angles. Okay, in our previous videos we have seen about the line segment, line point, then the different kinds of basic terms in geometry. So in this video we are going to cover about the curves and angles. Everything about angles we are going to learn. Okay, and we are going to learn some new things. So let's move on to the topic. So the first topic that we are going to see is closed and open curves. You may learn about the closed shapes and open shapes in your previous classes. So now we are going to see about the closed and open curves. Okay, so you know about the curve, right? So here I have given some figures. So in this figure you can able to see some figures are closed like this, and some of the curves are not closed. So whatever is closed, whatever that starting point and ending point coincide with one another, that is called closed. Okay, if the starting point and ending point are not close or not coincide in the sense, if they are not joining together, that will be called as a open curve. Okay, so here in this figure 1, 2 and 5 are closed figures, and figure 3, 4 and 6 are opened figure. Okay, so this is about closed and open curves. Let's see the next one. So here I have given some more pictures regarding that closed and open curves. So just look at here this is open and this also open, but here just look at here, it is both of them are closed. How we are saying that whether it is a closed one or opened one? Because this is the starting point of this and this is the ending point of this. If these two points, that is starting point and ending point, are joining together, means like this, that will be called as a closed one. If the starting point and ending point are not joining together, that will be called as an opened shape or opened curve. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So here we have the three regions of closed figure. Like you can tell as a parts. Okay, so we have the three regions of a closed figure. Let's see what are they. Can you able to see the points on the circle? Some points are present inside the circle, some points are present outside the circle, and some points are lie on the circle. Can you able to see the three categories here? Some points are lying on inside, some points are lying on outside, whereas some are lie on the circle. So whatever points are lying inside the circle, that is called as a interior points. Okay, if it is a interior points, what is the meaning of interior points? The points which are lying inside the circle. Can you see that D, P, O and X? So these are the points are called as a interior points. Why? Because it is lying inside the circle, right? Am I right? So whatever points lie inside the circle, that will be called as a interior points. So whereas exterior points, in the sense, whatever points lie outside of the circle, that will be called as a exterior points. So here we have A, B and M are exterior points. Okay, like interior and exterior, one more types of points we have, that is boundary points. So just look at here on the circle, that line, that outline. So that outline is called as a boundary. Okay, so boundary means the outline. Okay, whatever points lie on the outline, that is the boundary. Whatever points lie on the boundary is called as a boundary points. Here in this picture, Q, N and R are present or lie on the circle, that is a boundary, on the boundary. Okay, so that will be called as a boundary points. So these are the three regions of a closed figure. Okay, first one is a boundary points, then interior points and then exterior points. So let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see the curvilinear boundary. Okay, curvilinear boundary, we know that boundary means it is an outline. Yes. So now we are going to see about the curvilinear boundary. Just look at this. So already we know the outline of the figure is called as a boundary. Here it is a curve, right? The boundary, that outline is a curved line. It is not a straight line, right? So if the boundary is a curved line, if the boundary of the shape is made up of curved line, that is called as a curvilinear boundary. Here I am going to show some pictures of the curvilinear boundary. Just look at here. These are the pictures for these are the pictures or example of curvilinear boundary. Okay, so whatever shapes that outline, the outline of the shape is made up of curved line, and if it is a closed shape, then it will be called as a curvilinear boundary. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. That is a linear boundary. Okay, now we have seen about the curvilinear boundary. Now we are going to look forward to linear boundary. Okay, so linear boundary, in the sense, the same thing, it should be the closed figure like curvilinear boundary. And if it is a closed figure and the boundary, that outline, are made up of a straight line, in the sense, that will be called as a linear boundary. Okay, just look at here. The outline of the shape is called as a boundary, and here the outline of the shape, that is the boundary, is made up of four straight lines. Am I right? So this is called as a linear boundary. If it is a linear boundary, the boundary will be made up of straight lines. If it is a curvilinear boundary, the boundary will be made up of curved line. Okay, so here I am going to show you some pictures for a linear boundary. Okay, these are the examples for linear boundary. It may be any shape, but it should have all straight lines. Okay, if it is all straight lines, then you can tell that as a linear boundary, and if it is a curved line, you can tell that as a curvilinear boundary. Okay, that's it. So let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see problems from Let Us Try 4.2. Okay, so the question number is S1, and the question is, draw a rectangle and name the endpoints of its sides. So first, what we have to do, we have to draw the rectangle and name the endpoints. So let's draw the rectangle. So here is a rectangle, and we have marked the end points. Okay, see, 4 points we have marked, no? So end points, in the sense, this line and this line is going to join here. So that four corners, that is called the end points. Okay, so we have marked the end points. Okay, now we are going to identify whether the end points are inside, outside, or on the rectangle. Okay, identify whether the end points are inside, outside, or on the rectangle. Where the points are lying, these 4 points, where it is lying, the end points are on the rectangle. It is lying on the rectangle. Am I right? It is on the rectangle only. No, it is not inside and it is not outside. It is on the rectangle. So you have to write end points are on the rectangle. And one more thing they have given, we have draw the rectangle and we have marked the end points also, but we didn't give a name. So if you want to give a name, what you have to do, just you have to give any name. It can be anything. Okay, but it should be the order. You should not change the order. Okay, so now I'm going to give a name for this A, B, C, and D. Okay, so these are the points we have marked on the rectangle. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Now we are going to see about the angle. Okay, do you know the meaning of angle? Do you know what is that angle? So here is a picture that representing an angle. Okay, so just look at here. In this angle, we have two arms. This is the arms. Okay, two straight line is there, no? These are the arms. Okay, what is the meaning of arm? The two straight line, with the help of the two straight line only, the angle is formed. So these two straight lines are called as a two arms. How many arms are there? Two arms. And where the two straight lines are meeting, these two straight lines are meeting at this point. Am I right? So this point, that meeting point, is called as a vertex. Okay, that meeting point is called as a vertex. And here, can you able to see this green color? So this is called an angle. Okay, this is called an angle. Okay, so let's see the next picture, then it will be easy for you to learn easily. So just look at here. Here I have drawn two straight lines. The two straight lines are meeting at a point P, B. Okay, these two straight lines are meeting at a point B. So B is a vertex. Okay, that meeting point is called as a vertex, and these two are the arms, and inside this two straight lines, they are joining together. No, now the angle will be formed. Okay, so let's see the next one. Now we are going to name an angle. Okay, how to name an angle, that we are going to see now. So we know that line segment, line, ray, everything we have seen how to represent. So now we are going to see about the angle, how to represent the angle. For example, if it is a line segment, we will write like this, AB. And if it is a ray, we will write like this, AB. Sorry, this is B, okay. So AB, if it is a ray, we will draw like this. If it is a line, then we will represent like this. Am I right? So like this, we will represent line segment and ray and then line. Now we are going to represent an angle. Okay, how to represent an angle, that we are going to see now. So just look at here. Here this ABC. Here is one angle and here is one angle I have given. Both are same. So this angle you can write as angle. For representing angle, you have to draw like this. Okay, angle ABC. Always this meeting point should be at the center of the name. Okay, you can write in any order. You can write ABC, or once again, so you can write in any order. You can write ABC or else you can write CBA, but the thing is, this vertex always, in whichever order you are going to follow, but this vertex will be the center of the name. Can you see that? Here I have written ABC and here I have written CBA. Both are correct, but in both the name, B is at the center. Am I right? So always the vertex should be the center. Okay, in this format only you have to write. One format is ABC or else CBA. Okay, so in this format only you should write. And here I have marked the angle as 1. So this can be write as angle ABC or angle 1. Okay, both are correct. These two are correct. And this should be read as, how to read this? This symbol I have given, no? So this symbol, how to read this? For example, if it is ABC, how will you read this? You have to read this as angle ABC. And if it is like this, angle 1. So this symbol should be called as an angle. While reading, you have to say this as an angle. Understood? So in this way, you have to name an angle. Okay. Let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to measure an angle. Okay. How to measure an angle, that we are going to see now. For that, we are going to use this device. Have you all seen this device in your geometry box? Yes, very good. You have seen this in your geometry box, right? So what is the name of the name of the device? Is protractor. Okay, so now we are going to use this protractor to measure an angle. Okay, so let's see how to measure an angle using protractor. So here I have shown a picture. So in this picture, we are measuring this angle with the help of protractor, right? So while measuring an angle, you have to place your protractor on the angle. Okay, in your angle, you have that baseline, right? See, just look at this protractor. Can you able to see this baseline? So this baseline, here only it is started, no, 0. Can you able to see that? Here only, from this line only, 0 is started. So where that measurement is started, but in this protractor, it is started from the end point here itself. From this point itself, it is started. So I have placed the protractor on this line itself. But here, if you are using like this, then you have to place this zero on this arm. Okay, and we know that, right? Angle have two arms. So that base arm, you have to keep this zero on the base arm. Okay. So like this, you have to keep your protractor on the arm. Then you have to count from zero. Always you should count from zero. Can you understand? Always you should count from zero. While you are using this side, you have to see the inner zero. That inside one zero is there, na, that you have to see. If you are using this side, okay, and always you follow this side alone, okay, don't use this side. Always you have to follow on this side, okay. So whenever you are measuring anything using protractor, you have to see from this side, understood? Okay, so we have placed this protractor on the angle and ensure that it should be that middle point. This is the middle point of the protractor, right? So this middle point is exactly placed on the arm, okay? And I will show you what are the do's and don'ts, then you will get to know easily. So here we have placed this protractor on the angle and we have started measuring this. Just look at here, 10, 20, 30 and then 40. Exactly at the point of 40, it is end. This arm is placed on at the value of 40, right? So what is the angle of this? That is 40 degree, okay? How to pronounce this? 40 degree. How to read this angle? 40 degree, okay? So likewise, you have to measure an angle using protractor, okay? Let's see the next one. So here are the steps to measure an angle using protractor, okay? So the first thing, you have to place your protractor so the center of the rotation is along the bottom line. I told you, center of rotation, in the sense this is the center point, it should be on the bottom line, okay? Bottom line in the sense this arm, okay? And step two is decide if you are using the inside protractor or outside protractor. I told you, you have to follow this side only, not this side, okay? Strictly you have to follow this side, okay? So let's move on to the next one. That is a step three. So the step three is, you have to start at zero and you have to measure how many degrees it is from the starting line to the finishing line. That we have seen already, no? For 40 degree, we have started from the baseline and we have finished from this line. So that was the measurement of that particular angle, okay? So let's move on to the next one. So now I have given what are the points you may miss while using protractor for measuring the angle. You have to line up the bottom of the protractor with the bottom of the line of the angle. This bottom line of the protractor should lie on the bottom line of the angle, okay? And you should not forget to make sure the vertex of the angle is lined up with the center of the protractor. Vertex should be on the center of the protractor. Center of the protractor is 90 degree, right? That should be placed on the vertex of the angle, okay? And you have to always, you should start at the zero. Always you should start at the zero and you should move upward, okay? And while you are using the protractor to measure any angle, you have to double check your measurement, okay? So let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see about the different types of angles, okay? So let's see what are the different types of angles here. So the first type of angle is right angle. What is the first type? Right angle. Right angle in the sense, an angle which is equal to 90 degree. This is called right angle, okay? If the angle is equal to 90 degree, that is called as a right angle. And right angle should be marked as this, a small square, okay? And the next angle is acute angle. What is the next angle? Acute angle. So acute angle means an angle which is less than 90 degree. If it is less than 90 degree, this is 90 degree. If it is less than 90 degree, that is called as an acute angle, okay? This is, if it is a 90 degree, if the angle is 90 degree, that is called right angle. If the angle is less than 90 degree, means acute angle, okay? So let's move on to the next one. That is straight angle. Next model is a straight angle. Straight angle in the sense, an angle which is equal to 180 degree. Okay, if the angle is equal to 180 degree, that is a straight line. If it is a straight line, then that will be called as a straight angle, okay? Let's move on to the next type. that is obtuse angle. Obtuse angle in the sense, an angle that measures more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. 180 degree means it will be called as a straight angle, and if it is 90 degree, it will be called as a right angle. If it is less than 90 degree, that will be called as an acute angle. And if the angle is more than 90 but less than 180 means it will be called as an obtuse angle. Okay. So next type of angle is zero angle. What is the next type? Zero angle. So zero angle means that angle which is equal to 0 degree. Here it will be CWHICH. Okay. So an angle which is equal to 0 degree. Just look at here only one arm is there. If it is an angle, we should have two arms, right? Everywhere we have two arms, but here only one arm, because the angle is equal to 0 degree. So there will be only one arm will be there. Okay. So that is called as a zero angle. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. So next angle is a complete angle. Complete angle in the sense, an angle which is equal to 360 degree. 360 degree in the sense that full rotation. Okay, that full rotation is called as a complete angle. The complete rotation is called as a complete angle. Okay, so that is called a complete angle. That angle which is equal to 360 degree will be called as a complete angle. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Reflex angle. What is the next type? Reflex angle. Reflex angle in the sense, an angle which is greater than 180 degree. Greater than 180 degree. If it is a straight line, that will be called as a straight angle. And straight angle means the angle will be equal to 180 degree. But if it is a reflex angle, the angle will be greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. Okay. Greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree means that will be called as a reflex angle. Okay. So just look at here, if it is a straight line, that will be 180 degree, but here it is more than 180 but less than 360. 360 means this one, no? Both the lines will be here. So this reflex angle is greater than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see about the turns and angles. Okay. So for turns and angles, first you should know about the direction. So here I have given the direction. That is north, south. Upside should be the north and down should be south, and right side should be east and left side should be west. Okay. Like this, you have to mark the direction. By using the direction only, we are going to do the turns and angles. Okay. So we know that right angle means it is a 90 degree, right? But before doing the turns, you should know about two terms. That is, one is clockwise and another one is anti-clockwise. Clockwise means if you are turning by this direction. Okay, if you are turning by this direction, it will be called as a clockwise. How the clock will move that direction. If it is, if you are turning by the direction of clock, it will be called as a clockwise. And if it is opposite to the clock direction, that will be called as an anti-clockwise. Okay, so now just look at this direction. This I have marked like this. Am I right? So this will be north and this will be south and this will be east and this will be west. If I asked you to rotate this direction by two right angle at right side. Two right angle at right side. Okay. Two right angle at right side. Right angle we know it will be like this. Am I right? Right angle means this one only, no? So what I said, you have to turn this by two right angle at right side. Two right angle at right side. So now we are going to do that. Okay. Let me erase everything. Then yes. So now we are going to do this. Two right angle. We are going to shift this. We are going to turn this by two right angle at right side. So two right angle, if I move right side, for first right angle, right side means this side. Okay. So for first right angle, this north will come here, east will go here, south will go here, west will go here. This is for the first right angle by right side. What is the question I have said? Two right angle by right side. So now we are going to move the second turn. So while doing the second turn, north will come this side. Okay, north will come this side and east will come here, south will come here, and here it will be west. So the final direction will be here it will be west, and here it will be north, and here it will be south, and here it will be east. Now can you understand how to do the turns and rotation? So likewise you have to perform the turns and angles. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So comparing angles using compass, what are we going to do now? We are going to compare the angle. Okay, we are going to compare two angles by using compass. So let's see how to do that. So if you want to compare two angle, you have to use your compass. Okay, if you are using your compass and you are going to compare, means first you have to divide your compass. Okay, and you have to keep your compass like this on the angle will be like this. No, that one end of the compass should be on the one end of the angle and another end should be on the another end. Like this you have to place your compass on the angle, and then without changing that measurement, without changing this gap, you have to keep your compass and you have to place it on the scale. Then you can measure the length. Likewise, if you are going to compare two angles, for both the angle you have to do like this and you have to mark, note down the measurement. Then you can get to know which is bigger than other one, right? Which is the bigger one, that you can able to find out, right, by using this measurement. So this is how you have to compare the angles by using compass. First, what you have to do, you have to place your compass, that one end of the compass should be on the one point of the angle and another end should be on the another point of angle, and without disturbing this measurement, you have to place it on the scale and you can measure it. Likewise, you can compare both the two angles, two or three angles, and you can conclude that which angle is a bigger one. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to move to the exercise. Let us try 4.3. okay, and the question number K1, the question is, name the angles in the following figures. Two figures they have given and we are going to name the angle. Okay, so for the first one, see, just look at here, angle ABD, that is the first one. So angle ABD we have written. Then angle ABC, students, please keep that in your mind, the vertex should be the center. Okay, angle ABC and angle CBD. So totally three angles are there. Okay, and the next one, for this figure, first one, angle PQR, then angle QRS, then angle RSP, okay, RSP, and angle SPQ. So totally four angles will be there. Likewise, you have to name the angle. Okay, let's move on to the next question. So the next question is, classify the shaded angle in each clock as acute, right, obtuse, straight, reflex, or complete. They have given the clock and they have shaded an angle in the clock. Now we are going to find out which angle is shaded in the clock. Okay, so let's move on to the first one. So this is the first clock they have given. Just look at here. Here it is, the two hands of the clock is showing us a straight line. So what is the angle given here? Straight angle. Okay, so what is the answer for this? Straight angle. Now we will move on to the next clock. Just look at here. Here they have shown an angle, and students, please keep that in your mind. Always you should, if it is a clock, if they are showing an angle using a clock, you have to check from the number 12. You have to check from number 12. Okay, so here it is started from here and it is moving here. If it is a straight line, means that straight angle means it should be towards 6. Here we have seen, no? But here the another hand is on 8. So it is more than 180 degree. So the angle is more than 180 degree and less than 360 degree. So what is the angle of this? That is reflex angle, okay? So this is reflex angle because the angle is more than 180 and less than 360, okay? Let's move on to the next one. So this is the next question. So here they have given the angle, and this angle is less than 180 degree, more than 90 degree, more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. So what is this angle? Obtuse angle, okay? So what is this angle? Obtuse angle, okay? So right angle means the angle will be equal to 90 degree, and a straight angle means the angle will be equal to 180 degree. If it is reflex angle, the angle is more than 180 and less than 360, and if it is obtuse angle, if that is more than 90 and less than 180. If it is acute angle, that is less than 90 degree. Okay, and zero angle means theta is angle will be zero, and if it is a complete angle or a full angle means that will be 360 degree. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So the next question is S3. Name five angles formed by the line segment in the following figure. So here they have given the figure. So here we are going to name any five angle. Okay, that is your choice. You have to write any five angles name. So let's see how to write a name of five angle. Okay, so the choice is yours. You can write anything at first. There is no wrong. You can write any angle as at first, okay? But the thing is, you have to write five angles, okay? So first I have taken angle A, B, C. Vertex should be the center. Here all three are the vertex, right? A, B, C. Where the two lines are meeting, that will be called as a vertex, okay? So angle A, B, C and angle A, B, D. Angle A, B, D, okay? Then angle D, B, C. Okay, then angle B, C, E, that also angle, okay, and angle E, C, A. Can you understand? So these are the five angles I have taken. If you want, you can take like this also. You can take, for example, D, angle D, A, E, that also angle only, okay, and angle D, F, C, that also angle, D, F, C. In the same way, angle EFC also you can write. Angle BFC you can write. That is your choice. You can write anything, okay? But you have to write five angles, okay? So let's move on to the next figure. So here is the next figure. Now we are going to write an angle for this, okay? So the first angle will be angle ABC. Then angle BCD. Then angle CDA, okay, then DAE, and then DEA, okay, these are the angles I have written. So likewise you have to write likewise you have to name any five angles or four angles, whatever they have asked in the question. Based on that you have to name it, okay? So let's move on to the next one. So the next question is S4 question. Compare the following angles using compass. Already I told you, you have to keep your compass. One end should be here and another end should be here. And you without disturbing that, you have to keep it on the, place it on the scale. And you have to note down the measurement. Likewise, here also you have to keep one end of the compass here and another end here. Then without disturbing this measurement, you have to place your compass on the scale and you have to note down the measurement. While seeing the angle itself, you can tell that angle B is more than angle A. So the answer is B is more than A, okay? B is more than A. B is, look, we can able to see that, right? This is the bigger one. So B is more than A, okay? That we can conclude. So let's move on to the next question. So the next question is, the hour hand of a clock is at 6. Where is the hour hand? Is at 6, okay? So if it is 6 like this, the hour hand is at 6 of the clock. It is turned anti-clockwise by a right angle. it is turned anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise in the sense it is moving to this direction. Sorry, our hand. This is minute hand. Don't take this. Our hand. So this is going to move on anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise means by use this direction. Okay. It is going to move anti-clockwise by a right angle. Find its new position. Anti-clockwise by right angle means first the our hand is like this. Okay, our hand is like this only. No, now if it is moving anti-clockwise means this direction. So if it is moving this direction by a right angle, then the angle then the line should, our hand will be like this. So the time will be, if it is shown in the clock, it will be showing like this. It will be on 3. So where it is now, where the hour hand is now, the hour hand is placed on 3. So that will be your answer. Okay. Our hand is placed on 3. So the answer is 3. Okay. We have to find out the new position only now. So new position will be 3. So let's move on to the next one. So the next question is, both the hour and the minute hands of a clock are at 3. Both the hour and the minute hands of a clock are 3. Let's draw the clock. So likewise, like this, both the hour hand and the minute hand of a clock are 3. Both hands, the two hands are on 3. Okay. What would you call the angle formed when one of the hands of the clock is rotated clockwise? Clockwise in the sense this direction. Okay. Clockwise in the sense this direction. Okay. If this is a clock, clockwise means this direction. Okay. So what would you call the angle formed when one of the hand of the clock is rotated clockwise by 3 right angle while the other hand remains at 3? So here two hands are there. One hand, it is not going to move. It is on, it will be stay on the 3. But one hand, it is going to move by rotated clockwise by 3 right angle. Okay. So one hand is going to rotate clockwise by 3 right angle. So in the first right angle, it will go to the number 6 in the first right angle. In the second right angle, it will move to 9. Okay. In the second right angle, it will move to 9. So in third right angle, it will move to 12. Okay. So what they have asked, what would you call the angle formed when one of the hand of the clock is rotated clockwise by 3 right angle? Okay. Now what is this angle? The angle is right angle. What is the type of angle? The angle is right angle. Can you able to see that right angle here? Yes. So the answer is right angle. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. Now we are going to see about triangles. Okay. So already you know about triangles. In triangles, so here can you able to see that the name of the triangle is ABC. Okay, ABC. So here this AB and AC and BC, these are all the side. Am I right? So these are the sides of a triangle. And angle A, here we have three angles: angle A, angle C, and angle B. Okay, so these are the angles of triangle. Okay, for writing angle, you have to use this symbol. And we have three vertices, that is angle point A, point B, and point C. So these are the vertex. The plural form of vertex is vertices. Here we have three vertex, no? So you have to tell that as a vertices. Okay, so side means this one, vertex means this joining point. And angle, you know that it, where the two straight lines are joining together, it will make an angle. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. That is quadrilateral. Okay. What we are going to see now? Quadrilateral. So if it is a quadrilateral, it should have four sides. Okay. Quadrilateral should have four sides and all the sides should be the straight lines. Okay. So just look at here. I have drawn the quadrilateral and I have named the quadrilateral as A, B, C, and D. So these are the sides. A, B, B, C, C, D, and D, A are the sides. Can you able to see this cross? This end and this end, this end and this end. That opposite sides are joining together. No, opposite points are joining together, right? So that is called a diagonal. What is this? This into mark. the joining the opposite side, opposite points is called as a diagonal of the quadrilateral. Okay. So just look at here. Here I have given one more quadrilateral. This angles, that nearby angles, these A and D are adjacent angle because it is nearby, no? And A and B also adjacent. And angle A and angle B are adjacent. In the same way, angle B and angle C are adjacent. Whatever is nearby, that is called adjacent. Adjacent means nearby. And angle A and angle C are opposite angles, right? These two angles are opposite angles, right? Angle A is opposite to angle C. Likewise, this AD, the side, AB, the sides AB and AD are adjacent. These are adjacent sides. And AB and CD are opposite sides. Can you see that? Adjacent means which is nearby, and opposite means you know that, right? So likewise, you can write adjacent sides and adjacent angle. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. So now we are going to see the problems in let us try 4.4. So the first question is a fill in the blanks. Look at the first question. The point where two sides of a triangle meet. Where the two sides will meet. That what is the name of the point? The point name is called vertex. Okay. So the point name is called vertex. And a triangle has dash vertices and dash sides. Triangle have three sides and three vertices. Okay. And a quadrilateral has four sides and four vertices. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. So the next question is question number S1. The question is, there are two diagonals in a quadrilateral. Each diagonal divides the quadrilateral into two unique triangles. Verify this statement by drawing a quadrilateral and its diagonals. There are two diagonals in a quadrilateral. Yes, we know that. So each diagonal divides the quadrilateral into two unique triangles. So can you see that? So this is the diagonals. Okay. So how many diagonals are here? Two diagonals are here. One is DB and one is AC. So this two diagonal divide the equilateral into two unique triangle. So verify the statement by drawing the quadrilateral and its diagonals. Yes, we have verified, right? So let's move on to the next one. So the next question is question number S2. Draw a quadrilateral and label it as PQRS. Can it be called quadrilateral PRQS? So first what we have to do, we have to draw the quadrilateral and we have to give a name PQRS. Let's draw the quadrilateral. So we have drawn the quadrilateral and we have given the name PQRS. Next question is, can it be called quadrilateral PRQS? Can we say this quadrilateral as PRQS? No, we can't. So the answer is no. Okay, we have to call this quadrilateral as PQRS only, not PRQS. There is no connection between PR. No, you should not say like that. Always you have to say like this, okay, in an order. Okay, the answer will be no. So I hope you all understand the concept and copy this, whatever I have given, copy this in your notebook and practice more number of questions. So if you have any doubt on this, kindly watch the video again and again. Then you may get a clear knowledge on this. Thanks for watching. Thank you.